Είμαστε με τον Πέδρο Σαντάνα, ο οποίος αυτές τις μέρες βρίσκεται στη Θεσσαλονίκη, γιατί κάνει εμφανίσεις σε γνωστό Latin Club της πόλης μας και ο οποίος μας έρχεται από την Αθήνα, όπου μένει μόνιμα, θα μας τα πει και ο ίδιος. Πέδρο, όλα και τα!
Hi, hello, παιδιά. Καλησπέρα σας.
Καλησπέρα ή bienvenido en Salónica.
Ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ. I don't speak very good Greek, okay, I will start from that, but I will try τότε. Εγώ 100% καλό παιδί.
Okay.
Όνομα μου είναι Πέδρο Σαντάνα, εγώ από το Καράκας, Βενεζουέλα.
Venezolano, entonces. Okay, we are going to make this in English, okay?
Yeah.
And if you can understand my English, I'm going to translate.
Okay?
En español. I will try.
Perfect.
All right. So, Pedro, cantante y entrenador, tragudistis que gimnastis, singer and trainer.
Yeah, something
both.
Like
which one was your first? Did you first start singing or dancing?
First singer.
Okay.
This is my profession from many years.
Okay.
I was singing from Venezuela with a very important band there, the name Los Melódicos.
And
after I traveled to Spain, I was living in Galicia for years. I was working with a big show around all Galicia. And after I moved to Madrid. In Madrid I spent 10 years. But because of the situation, you know, and in Spain is very difficult right now, and even I have in this time a personal problem, you know, I separated, I was many things, many things together in the same time.
Yes.
And one day I was talking with one friend of mine from Chile, his name is Felipe, he living in Athens. And we have a very good connection, like friends.
Ελληνάς. Felipe is Hellene, Greek.
No, Felipe is from Chile.
Ah, chileno.
Sí, from Santiago de Chile.
Ah,
but he speaks perfect Greek.
Que vive en Atenas.
Vive en Atenas.
Ah, muy bien.
Vive en Atenas. And he told me, Pedro, listen, come to Greece, to Athens. To have a time, to holiday, to clean your mind. After you decide, you will go back to Venezuela, or you will go to Finland, Switzerland, whatever.
China,
yes.
Australia.
Yes. This was one the destiny that I want.
Okay.
I want to go to Sydney. Because even I have a cousin there. But my idea no was living here, and I come here and I start to like. I find in a good time, I find a work with a singer, the name Notis Fakianakis. You can find
big name.
Yes, you can find this in YouTube, but Pedro Santana Notis Fakianakis, you will see.
See?
In 2010
okay.
until 2011.
So you first came to Athens in 2010?
10.
Did you like it? Did you like Athens? Did you like our country, first of all?
I am in love. I am here almost 3 years, and almost. And I am still in love with Athens.
Really?
No.
Okay, let's talk about Thessaloniki.
Every time I go to, you know, in the Acropolis.
Yeah.
I go. I am in love. I say, how much beautiful you can be.
Yes.
Always.
Okay.
And also, when I'm living in Moscato, is a area.
The area,
Athens.
Yes.
Okay, from my room. From my bed, you can see the Acropolis.
Wow!
So I see the Acropolis
every day.
I say, my God, how you can be so beautiful every day?
Yes. Everything started there.
Yes. Everything.
Pero hablaremos un poquito de Salónica porque estamos en Saloniki. Ας μιλήσουμε τώρα για τη Θεσσαλονίκη. How often do you visit our city?
I come here every Penti.
Every week?
Every week, I am in Rosa Negra. The truth for me, it's my break.
Yes, your break from Athens.
Yes, my time, because here, if you go out, you will find the sea in 20 meters.
Sea.
Yes, I like go to the cafeteria here in the Niki.
Le Forest Niki.
Yes. Drink coffee, look the sea, look the La Torre Blanca, the White Tower.
The White Tower, yes.
Yeah, I like all that. The sunset.
Yes.
Here is amazing.
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 Oh.
This is so beautiful. Thessaloniki for me, give me calm, give me relax. This
yes.
is the word.
Relax. Yes. So, what differences do you see between people who live in Athens and us people who live in Thessaloniki? Do you see any differences in our behavior, in our character?
I mean, here in Thessaloniki, maybe because it's a smaller, the people are more friendly, more, you know, more quiet, more...
Relaxed.
Alara more.
Yeah, exactly.
Se paracalo. You understand? In Athens, the people want to... Έλα μωρέ, πού να το γρήγορα.
Yes.
Here the people, δεν πειράζει μωρέ.
Τρανκύλα. Pedro, when did you start to sing?
Είπα να γεια μου, it's very nice.
Let's go back to Venezuela.
Yes, it was in Venezuela. After I lose, it was for by accident. Don't believe that I wanted to be a singer.
Oh!
But by accident.
Uh-huh.
Hey!
Hola!
The baseman player Dimitris.
Hola!
Javier Rico from Mexico.
Oh, Mexico! Viva Mexico!
Pinche güey. Telita Moscó.
Telita Moy.
Telita Moy. Dimitris Sedalí, el romántico de la salsa.
Ajá.
Kalamata.
Oh, Kalamata? You?
El príncipe de Kalamata.
Oh. Shall we continue now our interview? Okay, encantada.
Todos hablan español.
Sí.
All of them speak
Spanish. Sí, sí. ¿Griego?
Algunos.
un poquito.
Algunos.
Vale, vale. Entonces, you started singing by accident.
Oh, yeah.
What did you want to be when you were a kid? Did you want to be, I don't know, an architect?
No, bombero.
Bombero? ¿Qué es bombero?
The guy who go to
firefighter.
Yeah.
Oh. And what happened? How did you start singing?
And the life bring me there.
Yes.
Because I didn't have a work in this time, in this moment. I was the commercial.
Yes.
I was working like a commercial agent from the companies like Johnson & Son, American company.
Yes.
Chico product, for the babies,
mm-hmm.
Oscar
mm-hmm.
Mayer,
mm-hmm.
this kind of company.
Mm-hmm.
And I lose this work. And I was without work. I couldn't find work. And suddenly, one friend of mine, she said, "Pedro, you don't find work. You don't play guitar." I said, "Yes, I play guitar." Okay, I am a singer. If you want, we can go to one taberna.
Mm-hmm. In Caracas.
In Caracas, we can go to the taberna. You play guitar, and I will sing.
Yeah.
Okay, we go. Maybe the taberna was this like
yes.
Lobby the hotel. And he told me, "Okay." We will start to sing, but I have to go out. Now we're coming back. Something happened, you start and we will talk
yes.
later. Okay. He left. I am still waiting for him because he didn't come back.
He so, never came back?
Never. And the guy, the owner of the taverna told me, okay, I need to
start singing.
Yeah. And I say, but my friend, he lived for a while, but he will come back. I don't mind. You have to sing.
Now.
Okay. I called that and I start to... Make, you know, instrumentals.
Yes.
And I look in the door, it's, well, it's my...
Oh my God.
And I play and say, okay, what I can do? I cannot play 45 minutes the same.
Yes.
And I start to sing.
Uh-huh.
But when you are not a singer, you start, you remember the, how can I say, the estrofa?
Yes, the chorus.
Well. Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
But you, the estribillo.
Yes.
You don't know very well the song. So I start to play and I start to sing one song. After I say, okay, I don't know very well the song. I will start other song. I start other song. Finally, I sing like a 6-7 song, but...
You did a medley. Yeah, mix.
Okay, I finished and the people like a lot and the guy told me, they worry for you. I didn't believe because He paid me very, very, very good, very good money. And also was, he told me, okay, I will pay you this money, and this time was very good money.
Mm-hmm.
And also he told me, you will drink whatever you want, you will eat whatever you want.
Okay.
And even you can invite your friends to drink if you want.
And how long did you work there?
This was for a few time because suddenly one guy, he's the son of the famous singer in Venezuela. He was a drummer in this moment. Now he is a piano player.
Uh-huh.
But in this time he want to find a singer. He saw me there and he said, "My friend, you don't want to make a band? I have a, because I was playing only with the guitar. You don't want to make a band?" I say, "Okay, I will." And we start to cooperate. We make a band. And I left the taverna and start to play bigger, you know.
Yes, yes.
Working with King. After that, other guy, owner of the bigger orchestra, the
yes.
Salsa.
Uh-huh.
He saw me and he offered me work. I left the band. I start to be with the orchestra.
Uh-huh.
I start to singing with a lot of orchestra, very famous in Venezuela, like Dimensión Latina. You know, Oscar de León.
Sí.
He was the first singer of Dimensión Latina.
Sí, sí.
Los Melódicos, gente from Venezuela, people from Venezuela, they know
sí.
very well this.
Sí.
Los Melódicos, Magia Caribeña.
Mm-hmm.
I was singing with in almost in all the better club
in Venezuela.
The best club, yes,
sí,
in Caracas.
Sí. Pedro, as a kid, who are the artists, who are the singers that you admired? Venezolanos or Latinos in general?
When I was a little,
mm-hmm.
my mama didn't want I listen salsa.
No?
No.
Oh.
She said because in this time, hear salsa is not so good.
Oh.
No, only the bad people hear salsa. My mama say, no, you have to hear classic music. Even she want I go to study in the in La Filarmónica. To be a musician, but the flauta,
sí, sí.
classical.
Mm-hmm.
And she didn't want, I listen salsa,
mm-hmm.
but I take a little, I talk, I said to you about with 10 years old,
mm-hmm.
11 years old,
mm-hmm.
12, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
She give me for eat in the school.
Yes.
And I didn't eat nothing.
And what did you
I
do?
I keep the money
yes.
to buy my first LP.
Uh-huh.
You know, by
Disco?
Oh, yes.
Sí.
Héctor Lavoe, el cantante de los cantantes.
De Puerto Rico.
Exactly.
Sí.
Cantante de los Héctor Lavoe. This was my first singer that I fall in love and the I maybe I know all the songs.
Wow. Okay, Pedro. Now, can we speak a little about your other interest, tumbao?
Ay.
Tell us a few words about tumbao.
Tumbao, okay. Tumbao is a Latin program, okay, where I am the creator of tumbao. Here in Greece, I have to say that, first, the meaning, the word of tumbao, coming from Africa.
Mm-hmm.
The people, the Venezuela was under control of Spain. The Spain people, they bring people from Africa to work in Venezuela. Okay, these black people, when they were playing drums,
mm-hmm.
okay, this sound, they called it this sound tumbao because it's tumbao, tumbao.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And the way that they play, this is the meaning of tumbao, or the soul of the rhythm.
Mm-hmm.
With the time, we keep this name. When the people play very nice, we say, this guy have very nice tumbao.
Uh-huh.
And in the street, the normal people, when they say, when you see one girl very beautiful, walking very sexy,
sí.
She's walking very sexy, you can say, this girl have tumbao. La negra tiene tumbao.
Uh-huh.
La negra tiene tumbao, tiene tumbao, tiene tumbao.
¿Y dicen esto solamente en Venezuela o...?
No, en all Latinoamérica.
¿Sí?
En all Latinoamérica.
Uh-huh.
So, tumbao is the way that you play or that you walk. And I keep to me the way that you move, the way that you dance.
Mm-hmm.
This is the meaning of the word tumbao.
Mm-hmm.
And tumbao is is the combination, okay, the basic step of salsa, reggaeton, bachata, dembow, by choreographies, to start to learn the basic step of dance, Latin music.
So
it's not aerobic. This is what I want to say. It's not aerobic. It's choreography where you can learn the basic step of dance.
And you teach tumbao in escuelas, dance schools in Athens.
Yes, in the studio, in schools of dance. Right now, I have associated with Planet Gym. It's a networking.
See.
And we are really right now. Tumbao is go up a lot.
Do we like it? Do Hellenes like tumbao? We like it.
Yes, a lot, because something that is true that the Greek people like a lot dance.
¿Cómo los latinos?
I think even more.
Really? Maybe it's because you are teaching it.
Yeah.
Pedro. De nada. Which one do you prefer the most, singing or dancing?
If you see my show, you will see that I like singing and dance at the same time.
Really?
Yes, because I think that you can express with your voice, but at the same time, the feeling you can express with the body. It's very important.
Entonces, Pedro. Última pregunta, y no es una pregunta, es una request, un request, request. I don't know how it is in Spanish, but I want to ask you something in order to close this conversation. Could you sing something for us? Anything you like, something from Venezuela, anything, anything, it's up to you.
It's a song that the people, I hear the first time when I was a little, from Julio Iglesias, the singer.
Vamos.
But one day I hear here in Greece.
En griego?
For a singer, yes.
Yes.
And also it's very old. So I have a duda. If it's from Latin America or it's Greek song. Okay.
Vamos a escucharlo.
I'm going to say the name. Abrázame y no me digas nada, solo abrázame. Me basta tu mirada para comprender que tú te irás. Agápame y a ti nací sojoriasú, de jinete nera aquí su imu, que ta jinete tis petres digo noima afto. Agápame que exejas el hipompo para sirome, que gire palo a panomu, na jirume. Αγάπη μόνο αγάπη σου ζητώ.
Qué bueno, Pedro. Julio Iglesias y el griego Yanis Poulopoulos.
Sí.
Muy bueno. Gracias. Muchas gracias por esta entrevista.
Thank you so much for to Parapolit. I want to take the opportunity to say to all Elada, thank you for the how can I say, the love that you bring me every time. Not only when I sing, it's also with tumbao, because now I have instructors that they are working in tumbao. They win the life with tumbao. Even they say to me, Pedro, you changed my life, because now I find the way to make people happy. You understand? And this for me is very important. So I want to say to Elada, to all Elada, by your interview, thank you so much. I never will have how keep back. You understand? Only I can say Ferito Parapo.
Και εμείς ευχαριστούμε. Pedro Santana.
100% καλό παιδί. Okay, not always, but I try.
Thank you so much. Muchas gracias.
Bye.